History of Man overview, where the dimensional beings were infused into the physical. This is obviously a fascinating point because the proof of that is every human being, because the dimensions is the mind, while the physical body is the physical body. So every human being is proof of it, because in the dimensions you have no time, just like you have in your mind no time. You can jump time, you can do all kinds of wonderful and crazy things which drugs help to emphasize. And in fact, if one study reality, what remains even after death is just the mind. Many would call it the universal mind. And we will still do interviews on when we met the universal mind, which was fascinating stuff. But the important point about the infusion of the dimensions into the physical was the creation of the mind and the mind consciousness system. It was then created and infused through the relationships that was pre-designed, which eventually, not immediately in the beginning, but eventually became the soul construct. And the soul construct then meant that you could in your mind create all kinds of types of personalities, and then in the life overview they can take one personality out, and that continues as the soul and becomes the soul body, and you delete the others and you leave the information that is relevant in the Akashic record for the next life. So you at least have some form of timeline to walk, which was still in the beginning that was quite relevant, because there was a conflict between the various creator gods in terms of how much authenticity and authority should be given to this new creation, the merging of heaven and earth. So in a way, the whole Bible stories was like a form of a dichotomy where they would give you some truth and some bullshit and manipulate the information to such an extent that you would not realize that the relationship between the mind or the dimensions and the physical must be one and equal. Otherwise, you will create, in fact, a conflict between heaven and earth, and a conflict in heaven would manifest as a war in heaven, which is all the kinds of psychological problems that exist today in the mind, like depression and psychotic breakdowns, all kinds of stuff. That's in fact war in heaven, where you are fighting to be God, and you are fighting with all your creations, your children, which is all your personalities, to see which one will be dominant. And the dominant one, they could even take it out of you at your point of death and play around with these things. It's amazing the stuff that was actually happening and possible. Some of it's been experienced when they use various drugs. What you actually use, DMT or any of those kind of things, you will end up experiencing your creation and the combined creation of consciousness within the context of your plugging into it. So you'll have a view that you can access to a degree of it. Seldom having any form of beings coming through. Yeah, so we continue here with about, for instance, DMT or the drugs that cause you to hallucinate. Each one will have mainly different experiences. You will, for instance, have four or five people that's on DMT or on some hallucinatory drug, but they will not be in each other's minds or have the same beings in their minds. They'll have their own story because they plug in at different places in the consciousness, in the energetic framework of the mind. That was heaven. Heaven did not exist until it was created. It's a construct. It was a design. Before that, it was the heavens. It wasn't heaven like you understand it now, between heaven and earth. Heaven and earth is connected, where you would go as a soul. It is a complete energetic creation and a design, which in essence was the mind. And it was fueled through plugging the being into the physical, where the being in the physical would then, through an organization, the organs, draw energy from the planet, and that energy will then be sent to heaven or harvested by heaven, because it's standing, what they say in the Bible, all the, was it the corn or whatever, standing ripe on the field, somewhere in the Bible, talk about that, ready for harvest. So they would harvest the energy, and with that they would expand heaven. The point was simplistically that some wanted to be God. And not that they were God before, they just saw the opportunity. They didn't find God anywhere, so they decided that they were not satisfied with the other beings or brothers as their equals. They were not equal, there was great discrepancies, much abuse, and decided to want to be God. So they designed a system within which they will be God, which was the energy system. And the vine, the wine, where you would become overwhelmed with the energy. You'll see some of the beings will say, I'll now tell you the truth. And they become completely superconscious, believing that they know the answer and they are God and all of that, which is divine. It's divine. It is an intoxication that happens through energy when you are not living here as the physical, and you can go completely into the mind, and you have an overload of energy. You have too much energy to your supply. It's like drinking too much alcohol, and it takes over completely, and you get like alcohol poisoning in a way. You are completely poisoned, and therefore you become the only God, and everything else is a poison. And it's a fascinating thing that happens. Anyway, so this infusion has had obviously also another side effect, the side effect being that some of the designs that would be created within the mind would end up as physical things, you know, beds, machines, all kinds of stuff. They initially existed in the dimensions, and you even had races that specifically worked with particular things, like the Syrians was more into the mechanics, the robotics, for instance, so that from that dimensions, parts of those things ended up being created here on Earth within space-time, which is pretty cool. So, we'll continue with an overview of various aspects of the process thus far in further interviews.